we found out we were having Easton, and it was at our gender scan that we found out about his heart defects. We didn't know what to do. His very first heart surgery was at 5 days old. It was about 5 days after that he went into cardiac arrest and had to be put on life support.
We tried to fix the valve on several occasions, and we just could not get a durable repair. I mean, you're dealing with a heart that's the size of a plump strawberry.
It was hard. Long days, long nights. Dr. Turek pulled me to the side. He said that he wanted to give me my son back.
He was very ill, so we listed Easton for a heart transplant. We realized that Easton did not have a functioning immune system, and that's when the light bulb went off. Research colleague Louise Markert had developed about 25 years ago a way in which we could replace the immune system in children who are born without immune systems.
The thymus is the organ where T cells are made. You need T cells because they fight infection.
Louise had this idea that why don't we take the thymus and find a way that we can give these children a functioning immune system.
So we found a way where we could obtain tissue from babies having heart surgery.
The thymus sits on top of the heart. You need to take some of it out because it's in the way. And Dr. Markert said, well, I know those heart surgeons are taking thymus and throwing it away. What if I were to tap into that?
You can put it in the lab, culture it, and put it into the thigh muscle. And it's like planting tulips.
If a heart transplant patient were to receive a thymus from the same donor that they're getting a heart from, maybe that reprogramming of the immune system that would occur would also keep them from rejecting their heart.
It was explained to us that the heart and thymus would see each other as self, so Easton's body wouldn't fight off the heart. We told Ivy that we were waiting on a special angel to bring Easton a new heart. One day, his transplant cardiologist came in and said, you know, how do you feel about getting a heart transplant today? Ever since he got his transplant, he's been making milestones faster than we would imagine that he would. He climbs on everything. He jumps off of everything. He has a bruise almost every other day, just like any other 2-year-old boy.
If you look back, this was something in the making for about 30 years.
Talk about the joy of your life, you know, being able to help these children.
Having a supportive environment allows you to change the world. This was something that could only happen to you.
When we visit all the staff members, Easton just runs up to them, gives them hugs. They became a close family with us. It's, you know, it's like our second home being at Duke.